kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. So now the Patriots getting set to take over on offense. They're led by their quarterback from the University of Alabama, Mac Jones. Throwing, Jones. Hunter Henry brings it in. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8. Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33. First carry for Damian Harris, the Alabama man.
But we always talk about good down and distance, allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, 2nd and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. A lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. Now Jones, looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Smith. And he will have a Patriots first down, and he was able to get it by plenty. A gain of 8 on 3rd and 3. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line. On the give, this is Harris. Oh, now Harris lost it. It's a fumble.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Now on 2nd and 16. Jones over the middle. That's caught by Amari Rodgers. That'll be a gain of 16. And that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4-down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10. So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. Looking to throw, Jones. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Montez Sweat in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a 3rd and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Work now for Jones and the Patriots here after the sack. It's 3rd and long. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete. So 2 3rd down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a 3rd, and now they deal with 4th down. On 4th down, Matt Hawk to punt it away. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Jaguars go on offense, 1st down and 10. They'll start out on the ground, and Saquon Barkley. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. 2nd down. 2nd down and 7. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Rolling to his right. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up 3rd down. third down, he'll drop to throw. Toward the sideline, did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down. They'll look to throw now on first down. They'll roll him out right. Man open, that's Deebo Samuel. Well, he will go out right near the 35-yard line.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Wiggles free. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
All right, Brad, I know we're in early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. They'll set up a throw. Complete. Smith has it. Touchdown, Jaguars. Devontae Smith, 29 yards. And the Jaguars are on the board first here in this division round matchup. Well, we knew they had the crowd on their side. Their defense has already made a stop, and now here's an opening drive touchdown.
Yeah, how about the defense making the stop, offense feeling their momentum that they've generated, and turning into points on their side. So now you got a team working together, and you got the crowd involved fully on their side in this ballgame.
And in this playoff atmosphere, that 12th man means even more. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. So back onto the field come the Pats for their second drive. They're forced to play catch up early in this division round game as they search for a seat in the AFC Championship round. It's brought in by Harris. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. So mark off the yardage for roughing the passer.
And I've seen this before. On a screen pass, not only are you rushing the passer, you're rushing him deeper than normal. And I think a little frustration kicks in at the end. You're going to hit him anyway when you shouldn't.
He's going to let one go deep for Parker. And this one almost intercepted. Not a good throw there. Nearly an opening drive, INT.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, and you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
He'll return it from the six. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. A terrific return there, 27 yards all told. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And he'll get this up to about the 40. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. Here's a give to Barkley. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and two. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that's caught inside the 30. And he gets this deep into Patriot territory. A big play that time for Jacksonville. The thing that hurt on that play, the missed tackle, that allowed the extra yardage.
It's a matchup game in the NFL. You get the guy that you want isolated, have him miss a tackle, and off you go.
to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And this one nearly picked off. Yeah, kind of surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but get away it does, and it's second down. Second and five. This throw incomplete, nearly picked off. And with his pedigree, he doesn't drop many of those. But third down coming up. And now third and goal following incompletions on first and second down. Back to throw again. He'll buy some time right. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A 5-yard touchdown run. And the Jaguars have taken a 13-0 first quarter lead.
It's not much as perfect in football, but that's about as close to it as you're going to get. Score, force a punt, score again.
And both drives were impressive. The opening drive was, that last one was. Now on the other side, though, what's your psyche? You're really behind the eight ball.
You got to make sure you just hold in there. Survive the early storm. Relax a little bit and try to get back to your game plan. It's way too early for panic.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all, and let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
On second down, this is Harris, and he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Third down, Jones. And that is incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down. Here's Matt Hawk now as he's on to punt for New England. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. It's a return of five following a punt of 42 yards. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Give them a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. A handoff to Barkley. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he's got the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 49.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guy can take him the distance. But in short yardage, trying to pick up first downs, that big guy, always a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
So a solid run by Saquon Barkley, and another first and 10 here. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Flush to his right. And he will find his man, Samuel. Touchdown! Deebo Samuel, 49 yards. And the Jaguars continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Butker on for the PAT. And it is now 21-0. Just a four-play drive that time. And it results in a touchdown for Jacksonville. after the touchdown. Here's Butker on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And some dangerous territory. Already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down. Back to throw. Jones. Got a man open. That's Devontae Parker complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Looking to throw. Jones. It's caught on the right side at Smith. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. Back to throw. Jones firing quickly here, and that's complete. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards.
Well, this has certainly been a nice drive with the way they've spread the football around. Here, they even get the fullback involved in the passing game. That's got to cause a lot of consternation on the defensive side. You got to cover him, too. That makes things really difficult.
And he finds Parker here, complete. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line.
A very important third down conversion right there, because when you're trailing and find yourself this deep in enemy territory, the kicker's not even part of your thought process. You got to make it pay off with 6. Nice connection right there to set up first and goal.
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. That gets him 3 yards closer here as it brings up second and goal. And again, they'll go right back to their fullback. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Calling a gain of 2 as they're knocking on the door now. 3rd and goal. From the gun, Jones. Yeah, he's got it. Touchdown, Patriots. Devontae Parker from 4 yards out. And the Patriots get a score closer. Extra point by Sly is up and good, and the lead will be cut down to 14. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. And he's been good. 2 first half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence, does a great deal for your team, gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
Back to throw now on 2nd and 10. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down. The Jaguars on 3rd down. A perfect 4 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. They'll drop to throw. Flushed out right. And And this will be broken up and incomplete. Now a penalty flag down, and they may be going backward here.
Are you serious, dog?
So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up four.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Patriots take over. Here comes Mac Jones and the rest of the Patriot offense. 5 for 5 that last drive. Touchdown pass as well. He was clicking. Receivers, I don't want to be cliche, but running really solid routes too.
And what I love about it is when you look across any team, all right, the body types of the receivers are usually different. The way that they get open, different as well. Some of them use power to get open. Some of them use those head fakes and subtle moves. Some of them just use pure speed. And the really good ones, when they're established, they know how to push off at the end of a route, too.
Now a throw out to his fullback is complete. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Looking to throw. Jones. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Now the Patriots moving quickly, hustling up to the line. Going deep here for Parker. And this is taken in at the 5. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. But sometimes you just got to marvel at how these guys can throw the football. He gave that everything he had, and it was right up. They'll try and start this drive in the air, escaping the pressure right. Open man is Samuel, complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Sliding out of the pocket. That one tipped and it's incomplete. What good hands there defensively at second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll look to throw here. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers.
Got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. A great effort there. 34 yards. And the Jaguars add on to their lead.
That was a beautiful ball right there as he waited for his tight end to come uncovered in the end zone to give him points for patience as well. Delivered it right where it needed to be for 6 points.
Now to add the extra point. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. The drive summary, 4 plays, 75 yards. And it culminates in a Jags touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. Here comes Mac Jones and the rest of the Patriot offense. And he had the touchdown on the last drive, also 4 for 4. Very, very effective. What does he need to do to translate that forward into this drive?
Not think that what he saw in coverages last time is exactly what he's going to get again. He's got to play ahead and start thinking to himself, okay, we just did that. What are they going to take away now? What do we go to as a counter and continue to encourage his offensive line to continue to give him time?
They were really good on the last drive. That swung out wide to Harris, and he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Jones now on third and two. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Pat Surtain. An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging their defense now to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
They'll come out throwing here on first down, eluding the pressure right. And the ball is knocked out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
Can almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture.
And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down. Now Saquon Barkley. And he's going to come up a few yards short of the first. They get him to the ground at the 37. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. This would have been a 54-yard boot had they tried a field goal, but they will not try a field goal. They're going for it. Now back to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Jags come up empty on fourth down, and the Patriots defense is going to take over on down. The Pats at the line, ready to go. Now Jones, a final shot before break. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that is incomplete. So it's on to halftime. All right, hang on. We'll jump over halftime.
Final adjustments are underway in the locker rooms. Which of these two teams will survive and advance to next weekend's AFC Championship game? To find out, we go back to Brandon in charge.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Second half begins with a run from Barkley. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 53 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
Now a play fake here on first down. Rolling to his right. And he'll just get rid of it.
Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
And he stopped immediately there. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
This defense could use a few more plays like that right now.
It certainly could, but think about it from an offense's perspective right now. They've got a lead, but they don't want to throttle down too much and stall themselves. Still want to move at a nice pace.
Out of the gun now on third down.
Got a man. It's Waddle complete.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down, that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think think the defense fell asleep with the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try to put the hammer down and finish this one off.
And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. 18 yards on each of the last two plays, and they're picking up big chunks now. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Again, he'll drop to throw. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield. But when push came to shove, they stood their ground, and now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
They'll roll him out right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
Butker's kick here is good, and that'll push the lead up to 17. So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
So here are the Patriots now. They get ready for their first possession of half number two. Throwing, Jones. He gets it complete to Harris. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the screen there. It's second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. To throw again on second down. Jones. Open man is Kendrick Bourne. And he's brought down after a very nice gain.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football right now. I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
From the 44, Jones. And right side, Henry's got it. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Let's go.
Nice idea, nice concept there. Line him up on the left side of the formation, let him sneak his way across, coming back underneath, put it in his hands, let him get a few more yards after the catch, too.
Great way to utilize a tight end on the drag route. Now Jones. He finds his man complete. That's Harris. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 3 yards the gain there, second down. On the delay, here's Harris. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Here's Jones from the gun on third down. Wide open receiver complete. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They hand this off to Harris, and he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. fake. Jones. And he's going to be dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. Montez Sweat picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Interested to see what they dial up here. Third and goal with a lot of green between them and the end zone. Back to throw. Jones. And that is incomplete.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive. And finally, I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They saw the double coverage on him. Made it very tough for him to get the ball.
And this one is right through. And that will close the gap down to 14. So that maybe not exactly what they were hoping for, but it does get them back within a couple of scores.
And at this point in the third quarter, you don't have much margin for error, and that means you can't have drives that end with nothing. Whether it's a punt, a turnover on downs, those have to go away. You have to end with a kick, either a field goal or an extra point after a touchdown.
Here again comes the captain of this offense, leading his crew back out there now. And the stats on the screen tell the story. A great start. This defense, they've made some good adjustments, though. He's fallen off since.
You have to like what they did at the half, but you also have to like the fact that they hung in there. Despite the fact they had a tough first half, he was locked in, right? Rocking and rolling. They came out, made their adjustments, got their confidence back. Now they're causing him all sorts of trouble.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They begin with a run by Barkley. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Well, sometimes as a running back, you've got to be able to improvise when the hole's not where you expect it to be. But in this case, there wasn't any improvisation that he could do that was going to work. Kind of like if you're trying to be a comedian on open mic night at the Improv and you run into a tough crowd.
And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Clearly wasn't outside of the tackle box. There's your penalty.
And accompanying that penalty, a loss of down.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Well, we quit counting yardage on that one, didn't we? That was truly third and a mile, wasn't it?
It was. I thought they might just go underneath, but they didn't. They wanted to get the first down there.
Yeah, they tried to pick up the huge chunk unsuccessfully. I'm with you. I would have tried to take some yardage just to gain some field position.
It's a 45-yard punt, just a one-yard return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
Looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder. It puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. From the 45 on second down, Jones. It's brought in by Harris, fighting him off, and he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Jones throw into the hands of Henry here. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Jones on first down. And incomplete on the deep ball.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. He finds his man complete. It's Harris. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. New England on third down. They've converted six times and could use a is third and four. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. And the Patriots are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They run with Harris. Oh, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Damian Harris, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point by Sly is up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. This will be fielded inside the five. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And this has been a tight game to this point. Of course, they usually are at this juncture of the playoffs. But with the lead in the football, the clock right now, their friend, as they try to book their spot in the conference championship next Sunday. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself, because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs. And they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
67 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 13 times. So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 43. Looking to throw. Flush to his right. This will be caught. It's Samuel. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line.
These guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Down here in the red zone, you know your tight end's going to be a favorite target. Couldn't hang on.
And sometimes they just have to get out of their own head, because they understand how tight windows are there and how many bodies are there. And sometimes they just overthink it and don't catch the ball.
Flushed it, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Matt Judon, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. And boy, on this drive, it looked like the offense was really moving the football. I mean, they have been moving the football, but now they're in a tough spot. Nice play defensively.
Certainly felt like the defense decided to answer what the offense was doing. Okay, you're doing pretty well there. Guess what? We're going to bring some pressure. See if you can handle that. And they got to him on second down, and that sets up a third and long. Advantage defense.
He'll look to throw. Going for it all. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. Butker's kick here is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So that's, CD, an important one here in the fourth quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a two-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a two-score game, and they were able to get it done.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. They need to come up. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way down to the 37. A big play there for New England. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Off play action. Jones. He's got this one complete to Rodgers. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Amari Rodgers. 37 yards. And the Patriots are back within a score. Extra point by Sly is up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. This will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. I don't want to say that they're completely against the wall here, Charles, but all of a sudden, with the run that they've been on the other sideline, this is down to a three-point game. They got to be careful.
Not much space from their back to the wall, though. So you're exactly right. They've got to be careful here. But this is where the value of note-taking and recall comes into play. What was working earlier? Why was it working? Can you get those types of matchups again? And can you run those plays that'll get you a little bit more breathing room and a little bit of space?
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. They'll look to throw. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And this one is incomplete.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over it, and they got there to break that one up.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. A give to Barkley out of the gun. Takes this to the 32, maybe the 31, and then the defense rallying quickly after that broken tackle. 74 yards on the ground for him so far. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive, not much since. They'll run it again with Barkley. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Second down and 8. Shotgun, they run with Barkley. Now third down is looming. A pickup of 2 on first down and just 1 yard there.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete.
They went with the dive look that time on defense. Just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
They're going to look to throw. To the sideline, and he's got it. They say the feet are down. Yes, the line judge says they're in. That'll be a first down. So first and goal. 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great play there. A beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Jaguars are drawing closer to a day in the AFC title game as they extend this fourth quarter lead. And now remember, all touchdowns are reviewed, and in a tight game like this, they're going to take a good long look at it. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Extra point by Butker is on target, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And he'll just just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. Jones now on first and 10. Open man is born. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find a soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do, because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot that they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do, because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him.
Here's Jones. Pass complete to Harris. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Jones. And the Jags get to him as down he goes. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. To throw is Jones. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. He's got a man complete. And they've got it well across midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Now here's a throw that's complete. A gain of 6 there on first. Now the Patriots moving quickly, hustling up to the line. And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over at that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 13-yard line. And he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter. Slide for the PAT. And the lead is down to a field goal now. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told, and it ends with a New England touchdown. So with an even 30 seconds to go, everything will come down to this onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. And they will take a knee here. So 2 down, 1 to go, and this number 2 seed definitely looking the part, and now they sit 1 win away from a Super Bowl appearance.
Yeah, and I know originally they were disappointed not to get the number 1 seed and the bye through to the divisional round. But you know what they're saying right now? Let's just keep rolling. We're in a great spot.
And Bohorquez on to punt as he gets it away. The Jaguars season will continue at least one more week as we say so long.